Leck and Greg Vegan Camp, the 29th of April 2019.
So when the mangoes are touching the ground, it's not so good because when they get moist and stuff, then they might rot. And so we try to support them if they're like close to the ground with sticks or bamboo or whatever. And you need to be careful for like red ants. Mostly the red ants are in one part of the orchard. Keep them off the ground. Most of the mangoes are bagged, and what we do is, or what I do is I just touch them and feel how big they are. And if they're like rock solid, I just leave them on the tree. But if they're like a little bit soft or they have cracks, I feel for cracks. So if it's cracked, then I remove it from the tree. And here I can feel there is a crack. And if you're not sure what you're doing, if you're not sure if it's cracked or what is going on in the mango, you can always open it. But I can feel that it's cracked, so I already just take it off from the stem. I just break it there at the end of the stem here, and then I can also just like remove the bag like this, and you can see it's cracked and sick. Like if it has marks like this, like alien skin. So just throw it on the ground. If the bag is with holes, you just rip it and just put it in the... If there are like flowers here and these are dead, then we can remove these from the tree. So it will give more energy for these to flower, and we have like some mulch, and we don't have dead plant material on the tree that attracts flies and other bugs that we don't want in the mango tree. And ants are like the garbage men of nature, so if something is rotting, they will just go and clear it up. If there's a lot of rotten stuff on the tree, the ants will come and try to clean it up. If you can feel it's like a big one and you want to, if you're here for like pick your own, you can like feel it, okay, it's quite big, and you can open it and you can see, okay, if the tip is like getting a bit orange, it's ready, or like if it's like orangey and like this, then it's ready to pick, and you can bring it back home and ripen it back home. It's good for transport when it's like quite hard. And this process, this is something we try to do every other day, to just clear the mango trees from cracked mangoes and to find the tree ripened ones that we can eat or we can freeze. When this is like already dead, there are no mangoes here anymore. Then we just...
How do you know it's dead? It's
dead because there are no flowers, they're like already, it's dry, and you need to compare it with one that is alive. A dead mango here, break it off at the stem, it really comes off easy. Normally you will have like a mango hanging or a couple of mangoes hanging on this one, and then you can harvest the mangoes by breaking this up, and then you have mangoes. This is one of the ones that are alive. We don't want to take that one off because it has flowers that are alive and they might get mangoes. There's a red ant hive here. The leaves are like packed into a like a home, and it's like a red ant hive. I think the red ants are like protected. What can you feel?
Slightly softer, but I'm scared to press too hard.
If you're not certain, then you can open it. And if it looks like that, this is an organic tree ripened mango. This is how it looks. It already has a little bit of a black spot. That is, it's definitely, you need to harvest this.
Okay.
If it's not overripe even. Or just, yeah.
What is this, sap?
Yeah, or maybe even a bug going in. And it's okay to be a bit rough because these there are like mega storms doing like this. So actually, in some cases we will see mangoes that are tree drop because after the storm. But it's also a good way to find ripe mangoes if you're a bit rough. If it falls down by accident, it's probably because it's ready to be picked anyway. Most of the mangoes are packed in bags, but some of them are not, because some of them are like, were not beautiful, or we didn't know if they come out right. And as they say that sometimes the ugly duckling turns out to be a beautiful swan. So some of these unbagged ones are actually quite nice, and let's see if they how they turn out when they ripe. Here's an example of a small one that didn't make it and also already cracked without being bagged. It needs to go off also. The dry season, also here in April, has been so rough on everything. And this is our oldest avocado tree. And yeah, I don't know if it will survive. I probably will. But it has, it was very rough for the trees. When you have mangoes that look like this, where the bag is completely tied into, it's been bagged wrong, maybe because it was too young when it was bagged, so it's hard to bag. But then I open them so they will get more space, and then I just bag them correctly. That means I just make a wrap here and then just turn this around so they have this, they have space, they're not completely tied into the bag. The mango needs space to grow. There's a hive, beehive, natural beehive. So we didn't bag those mangoes because we were scared that the bees will do something. We don't want to go too nearby the bees, but they're good for pollination. Another beehive. This is the tree ripened one. It's still a bit firm, but soft, and it's really it already has black spots. And this one is an already probably overripe. It's very soft. You can see already here in the bottom, it's already overripe and almost rotten. Some people value the mango for its sweetness. I like the sweetness too, but I also like a rich flavor, different aromas. And this is what you get from tree ripened stuff. As you can see here, it's completely hard and firm. And here it's completely overripe. And as you can see inside, you have the seed here. But here you can also, this is a little piece of the seed. But it's completely, almost also super overripe inside, even though it's super firm here.
Really strange, because so if you peeled just one millimeter more, then it would be soft all the way. It's just it has 1 millimeter.
Then you can just cut that off if you want.
High peel, yeah. I mean, it's you can eat it. It's just not what you're used to when you buy mangoes usually.
No, so that's the difference between tree ripened and ripened in a box.
Maybe it's even better to ripen in a box.
Maybe.
Tasty.
I guess this is almost sick. These black spots are sickness. You need to remove them. I don't even know if it's a good idea to eat stuff like that. But it's if you're used to buying mangoes on the market, you will see these spots. It's not, even though they say ripe and rye or whatever, it's not good.
This is much better. Yeah, this is good. This is, you can taste the, there's some compounds that you can taste in this that taste like the more aromatic, the more, the mango.
Cut off some of the bad parts and then put it in the refrigerator so we can make salads when we want.
This was a split mango.
Put small pieces in your vegan ice cream or smoothie, and it gives you the sour taste. Limes are hard to get right now because they're expensive this season also, and it's very dry, so there are not a lot of limes. Our lime right now is mango.
My lime is passion fruit.
Longan season coming up next. Chom. Can even eat it raw. Casper doesn't like chum, but I love it. Some mango harvest. Thank you.